how you did this last time?
Last time I just pulled straight from this mic. This time okay. I'm pulling. I'm doing it just the same way we do it fast.
I tested it a few times. It's good.
I guess it's kind of a small thing, but it's description.
No, you can leave that. That's fine. I would say just, baseball. I think they actually prefer just to test Pitt. Yeah. Now, that's fine, but when we were saying Panthers with it, they went, looks good.
Sounds good.
Awesome.
That's for baseball.
Full-time and herbal sports. The other night it sounded all right, so
okay.
Hopefully it's the same deal today. Which internet are you on? I heard it the other night, it sounded.
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna see if I can get a little stronger internet up here.
Sounds good.
Someone else, but not for me. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to John Sessions Stadium for tonight's matchup, presented by Crystal Clean, featuring the visiting Pitt Panthers. Featuring the visiting Pitt Panthers and your Jacksonville Dolphins. Whether you're a small business or a big retailer, our friends at Crystal Clean are here to help. Their crews are trained and equipped to transform your property into a clean, sanitary, and inviting environment with minimal interruption to your customers or staff. Call 904-220-3337 or visit them online, crystalclean.com, for more information. No matter the size or scope of the work, they will get it crystal clean. Crystal Clean, official partner of JU Athletics. Fans, this evening, please be alert for batted or thrown balls or bats that may cause injury to participants or spectators or damage to personal property and fans. Safety protocols. We ask that you do not retrieve any of the game balls that leave the playing field. Also, fans, please make sure you're wearing your mask or face covering throughout your time here at John Sessions Stadium this evening. Also, please make sure that you adhere to social distancing protocols. We appreciate your attention and consideration to this matter. Fans, you will find QR codes posted throughout the stadium that you can scan with your smartphone. Those QR codes will link you to the game day program and to tonight's rosters. If you have any questions, ask a game day staff member. Fans, be sure to check out JUDolphins.com and follow the Dolphins on social media on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. That way you stay in the loop and get exciting up-to-date news and content. That's JUDolphins.com and all Dolphins social media. Join Duncan Kids Club today. With free or VIP membership, kids can enjoy free admission to games, free JU swag, and much more. Sign up online in the fan zone of JUDolphins.com and follow at Duncan Dolphin on Twitter. Duncan Kids Club, join today. Doubletree is known for their delicious warm chocolate chip cookies baked fresh daily. The cookies represent the constant dedication to the guest experience. Yours, you feel special and cared for throughout your stay. Book your stay today at Doubletree by Hilton Jacksonville Riverfront, a proud partner of Jacksonville University Athletics. The JU Dolphins would like to thank the team behind the team, Baptist Health. Proud to be the official healthcare provider of the Jacksonville Dolphins. Baptist Health, changing healthcare for good. Fans, a friendly reminder that the restrooms are located just down the stairs on the first base side of John Sessions Stadium. JU and the A-Sun promote good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting players in a positive manner. Profanity, racial, or sexist comments, or any other intimidating actions will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. Thank you for your cooperation.
Just take some time to build. commercial break if they can hear still or not. And then we may have to get to the point where you got to mute in between innings or whatever, and you can do that.
Yeah,
I'll let you know.
Sounds good. Thank you.
evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to John Sessions Stadium for tonight's matchup, presented by Crystal Clean, featuring the visiting Pittsburgh Panthers and your Jacksonville Dolphins. Now let's meet the starters for tonight's game, presented by Baptist Health and JOI. First, for the visiting Pitt Panthers, leading off, playing third base, number 3, Sky Duff. Batting second, playing right field, number 1, Nico Popa. Batting third for Pitt, playing left field, number 21, Kyle Hess. Batting fourth, the designated hitter, number 23, Ron Washington. Batting fifth, playing second base, number 24, David Yawney. Batting sixth for Pitt, playing first base, number 15, Bryce Hewlett. Batting seventh, catcher, number 33, Riley Walsh. Batting eighth for Pitt, playing shortstop, number 11, Brock French. And batting ninth, playing center field, number 5, Jordan Anderson. Tonight's starting pitcher for the Pitt Panthers is the right-hander, number 36, Dylan Lester. Panthers are led by head coach Mike Bell, assisted by Ty McGahee, Matt Rita, Devin Mazzarocco, and Nick Yarnell. Now, fans, here's tonight's starting lineup for your Jacksonville Dolphins. Leading off, center fielder number 4, Ruben Samayan. Batting second, shortstop number 2, Dakota Jalila. Batting third for the Dolphins, left fielder number 26, Tommy Joseph. Batting fourth, first baseman number 8, Christian Koipel. Batting fifth for JU, catcher number 18, Corey Heffron. Batting sixth, the designated hitter number 7, Stephen Moffitt. Batting seventh, the right fielder number 23, Blake.
Welcome to the following presentation of Jacksonville University Athletics.
Jackson Grabski.
Last year we saw a season cut short, dreams dashed. A return to the postseason thwarted by an invisible opponent. While there are plenty of new faces in green and gold this year, the end goal stays the same. Omaha.
The Dolphins are led by head coach Chris
and Samayan shoots one the other way into left center field. Sliding into second base, Ruben Samayan with a 2 RBI double. Koipel drives this one out into deep center field, and we'll see ya. Fourth home run of the year for Christian Koipel, a 2-run jack. Payoff pitch swung on and missed. Temple with his 6th strikeout of the day to finish 7 strong. How about this? He has thrown 19 straight scoreless innings. 1-2 to Heffron, and he turns on one, driving it out to deep left field, hooking toward foul territory. That's a fair ball. Heffron, and he's standing up with a triple back up the middle. Jalila Field steps on the bag at second base, relays on to first, and a double play ends the inning. Dakota Jalila, so slick in the field, makes it look easy. Swing and a miss. Casala strikes out the side here to close it out. Koipel into right center field. This is falling in for a base hit. Jacksonville wins on a walk-off RBI single from Christian Koipel.
The 2021 Jacksonville baseball team has some unfinished business.
It's time to play ball. Jacksonville University Baseball is presented by W.B. Mason, the official office supply provider of the Dolphins. Now let's head to the ballpark and join the voice of the Dolphins, Scott Manzi.
Thank you.
A beautiful night for baseball here on the first coast of Florida. Jacksonville wrapping up a four-game homestand here this Tuesday night, welcoming in the Pitt Panthers of the Atlantic Coast Conference for a one-game midweeker. I'm Scott Manzi, and we are getting ready for some JU baseball here as Austin Temple takes the mound for the Dolphins, making his first start of the season. Temple coming off of his best season as a Jacksonville Dolphin, in which even in the shortened campaign, he showed signs of being absolutely dominant. His season last year, he wrapped things up leading the A-Sun in ERA amongst qualified starting pitchers. Pitched to a 0.71 in four starts last season. 25 and a third innings he logged. He struck out 29, walked 10. Opponents hit just .163 off of the long right-hander. And he gets a chance to show his stuff for the first time here this year. Dealing with a little bit of an injury bug in the offseason, but he hopes that he has put that behind him and he is ready to get his 2021 season off to a good start. He faces off against a Pitt Panthers team that went 2-1 opening weekend. They play down in the Snowbird Classic down in Port Charlotte, Florida, and are continuing their Florida swing. Went 2-1 against the Indiana State Sycamores.
Leading off for
Ty Duff, the third baseman, to be followed by Nico Popa and then Kyle Hess, the top three in the order here this wonderful evening. Not a cloud in the sky, the moon overhead here at John Sessions Stadium, registering at 65 degrees here as we get ready for first pitch. Duff, a left-hander, stands in. The first pitch from Temple, and a fastball catches the inside corner for strike one, and we are underway at 6:03 p.m. Temple sets and fires, and just a little bit high there to Duff to even the count at a ball and a strike. Duff, a sophomore, 5'9", 180 pounds from Chemung, New Jersey. Here's the 1-1. Ball there and ruled to have just missed a little bit. That could have gone either way, that have both gone against Austin Temple after he started off 0-1. He's behind in the count 2-1 against Duff. And deals. Fly ball out toward left field, tracking to his left. Tommy Joseph reaching up. That ball carries over his head and out to the warning track. Cruising into second baseman Duff. And a leadoff double for the Pitt Panthers third baseman.
Right fielder, number one, Nico Popa.
That ball had some late carry on it, and Joseph was unable to track that one down, a circuitous route to the baseball. And it ends up over his head and at the warning track. And Pitt with a runner in scoring position here in the top of the first. Duff with his third extra base hit of the year. All doubles. Nico Popa starting in right field tonight. His fourth start of the season. He's 5-for-12 on the young Temple from the stretch. First pitch fastball upstairs. Popa has a younger brother on the team as well, Dom, a freshman. Popa, Nico, that is, a senior, who's from right in town, a Pittsburgh boy who stayed home. The 1-0. And he misses a little bit high there as well, 2-0. Temple with a long look to second base. Popa with the bat on his right shoulder, and he rips one out to deep left field. Joseph going back on that one to the wall, off the top of the wall and left. Easily scoring on the play, Duff. And an RBI double for Popa, and Pitt is off to a great start here in the top.
Batting for Pitt, left fielder number 21, Kyle Hess.
So Temple still looking for the first out here in the first, a runner in scoring position. Popa, after he scores Duff on the RBI single, and here comes Kyle Hess, who swings left-handed. And there is a fast, or it looked like a changeup there on the outside edge, called for a strike. Nothing and one, the count on Hess. I'll look back to second. And Temple comes home and goes off speed again, and Hess pulls the string. Nothing and two. Temple certainly has executed some pretty good pitches here in the early going. Some that just unfortunately didn't go his way as far as calls are concerned. And credit Pitt, because they have jumped all over the ones that have been left over. 0-2 pitch. Fastball popped up into foul territory left side. Giving a look, Grabski. He's over near the terrace. Reaches back and makes the catch. And that is a much-needed first out of the inning. And Jackson Grabski, the freshman, making a nice play in foul territory to make that catch. Already been introduced to Tommy Joseph out in left. Ruben Samayan making the start out in center again with right fielder Blake DeLamelor, the freshman tonight. Grabski over at the hot corner for the fourth straight game. Dakota Jalila at short. Jesus Pacheco, another freshman, at the keystone with Christian Coypel at first base. And Corey Heffron doing the catching of Austin Temple. One out, runner at second base, 1-0 Pitt, top of the first. Here's the first pitch from Temple, and he goes with a slider and locates on the outside end to Ron Washington Jr., a right-handed swinging designated hitter tonight. And no, he is not related to the former Rangers skipper Ron Washington. He apparently gets that question all the time, though, as you might imagine. The 0-1. Fastball at just a little bit low. Early indication that it's going to be a very tight zone tonight. Temple sets, kicks, deals, 1-1 pitch, another slider. This one is sliced into shallow right field. Rounding third, Popa, the throw into second base. Popa scores on an RBI single to the opposite field from Ron Washington Jr., and Pitt pushes the lead to 2-0 here in the top of the first.
Batting for Pitt, second baseman, number 24.
Another nice piece of hitting, taking a slider that hung out over the top of the plate and just shooting it the other way. Three hits here for Pitt off of Austin Temple in this top of the first inning. And the inning continues for the second baseman, David Yanni. Yanni 2-for-10 here so far. His lone hit, or his two hits are both for extra bases. He has a double and a homer. First pitch to the lefty swinging Yanni. Another good-looking pitch from Austin Temple, and that may have missed just a little bit up. Washington takes his lead, creeps out a little bit further, and Temple from the stretch, the 1-0. Locates right on the lead off first. Creeps out a little bit further, outside corner there for a strike. Sticks on the board, 2-0 Pittsburgh in the top of the first inning. And the Panthers with their fifth man to the plate here already have been opportunistic so far and have hit the baseball pretty well, the 1-1. Strike two called. Looked like another slider there from Austin Temple. Temple trying to punch out a man for the first time here tonight. He sets and deals. And a fastball way up and in, and it hits Yanni. I don't know exactly where that got him, but it sounded fleshy, which is a good sign because that was up near his head. And I think it might have got him right up on the shoulder area, maybe even under the neck.
Baseman, number 15,
and that looked like maybe Austin Temple trying to over-execute on a pitch and just lost the handle on it. So the hit batsman puts runners at first and second. One out here in the top of the first. And time called so that catcher Corey Heffron and shortstop Dakota Jalila can go in and have a word with the junior right-hander. Here's Bryce Hewlett, another lefty bat in the lineup for Pitt. The catcher Hewlett, 3-for-10, has started all four games this season for Pitt. First pitch fastball, runs a little inside on Hewlett, who spins out of the way of ball one. This inning started with a double to left field, followed up by another double to left field to score a run, a pop out in foul territory, an RBI single to right, a hit batsman, and here we are with one out, runners at first and second, and a two-run lead for Pitt in the opening inning. Unable to get that breaking ball to snap back in, and it's 2-0 now to Hewlett. Turn and a throw back to second base. Washington able to dive back in. And Jalila not in time to even apply a tag to attempt on that play. Shadows have almost entirely encompassed the outfield here at John Sessions Stadium as the sun sets over the St. John's River behind us. The 2-0 out for a strike. Back earlier this inning, we saw how the sun may have affected left fielder Tommy Joseph. On a little bit out there tracking a couple of fly balls. Now he is entirely in the shade. The 2-1. A slider again from Temple, and he is patient as to where these pitches are missing, and I'm wondering the same myself as his head coach Chris Hayes, who is now asking the question from the third base dugout. Maybe a better question is, how is Pitt taking these pitches? I mean, they're right there, the 3-1. Popped up into foul territory on left side. Grabski again may not have enough room this time. He doesn't. It lands into the terrace and loads the count full. Austin Temple looking for an out here. He's thrown 17 pitches already here in the first inning and has surrendered 3 hits and 2 runs. Hewlett with runners at first and second and one gone. The payoff pitch and a fly ball, a lazy one this time out to left field. A couple of steps back for Joseph, makes the catch, and no chance for anyone to advance. Two gone now in the first.
Betting for Pitt, catcher number 33, Riley Wash.
First for Pitt, Riley Wash doing the catching here today. Wash making his third start of the year. He's 2-for-7 thus far. And he swings it right-handed. Runners at first and second, two gone. First pitch, and Wash takes a fastball at the letters for a strike. Wash, a junior, 6'2", 192 pounds, one of several Floridians on this roster for Pitt. Hails from Altamont Springs, Florida. Here's the 0-1. Swing and a miss, got him to chase a slider down and away. Temple gets the sign. Deep breath, kicks and fires, 0-2 pitch, swung on and missed, blew a fastball past him and gets a strikeout to end things, and all things considered, does a nice job to mitigate the damage here in what was a stressful first inning for Austin Temple in his first start of the year. Two runs for the Pitt Panthers off three hits in the top of the first, and they lead as we head to the home half. Jacksonville getting its first wraps when we return. You're listening to Jacksonville University Baseball from Van Wagner on the Jacksonville Dolphins Sports Network.
2021 has officially begun, and JU Baseball needs your support.
While the world is staying home, the need to save lives never stops. Those of us who are part of the Baptist Health family know that the work we are called to do has never been more important than right now. So, to everyone who has made sacrifices, big or small, in order to continue serving our community, thank you, Baptist Health, the official healthcare provider of the Jacksonville Dolphins.
DoubleTree by Hilton Jacksonville Riverfront resides on the south bank of the St. Johns River in downtown Jacksonville. DoubleTree is where an exceptional locale blends with an array of amenities, personable service, and a better night's sleep. When we're not napping in our luxe bedding, you can probably find us relaxing by the riverfront pool, jogging along the riverwalk, or sipping a cocktail at our on-site Roots Crit Steakhouse. DoubleTree by Hilton Jacksonville Riverfront, a proud partner of the Jacksonville Dolphins. Of the first inning, Jacksonville Dolphins getting a chance to hit here for the first time. Scott Manzi back with you here. 2-0, Pitt leads. A couple of doubles there in that top of the first inning. And two left on by Pitt after Austin Temple was able to settle in and get the final couple of outs in a row there to close things out and keep things close. Here early, Ruben Simayan, Dakota Jalila, Tommy Joseph starting things off for Jacksonville today.
All right, fans, let's hear it. Leading off for your Jacksonville Dolphins, center fielder number 4, Ruben Simayan.
So here's Ruben Simayan, the first Dolphin, the only Dolphin to have a multi-hit game so far this season. He had two hits on Sunday in the loss to Miami. He's 4-for-13 in the young season, leading the team with a .308 batting average. Ruben climbs in. And the left-hander takes the first pitch, a fastball at the letters for a strike. Pitt starter Dylan Lester, a redshirt junior, a right-hander, and he fires the 0-1. Down and outside with the heater. .182 start of Ruben Simayan's career as he takes a fastball downstairs for ball two. Now two balls and a strike to Jacksonville's center fielder. He is the most starts on this team. Active right now, one of a handful of Dolphins to return this year. The 2-1 pitch grounded to the right side, fielded by the first baseman Hewlett. And he tosses to the covering pitcher, Lester, for round number
Betting
one.
For JU, shortstop number 2, Dakota Jalila.
One gone here in the first. Jacksonville trailing 2-0. And here comes Dakota Jalila. The redshirt senior shortstop started his career all the way back in 2016. First pitch, fastball at the knees for a strike. Kodak. Lester wastes no time, comes home with the 0-1, a breaking ball that Jalila checked his swing on. The appeal to first confirms he did not go around. And Lester comes home and misses again. This one a little bit low. 2-1 in favor of Jalila. Lester well traveled for this Pitt group, the redshirt junior from Brenham, Texas, on his third school. The right-hander kicks and deals the 2-1. And Jalila smacks one hard to the left side, backing up on it. The shortstop Franks, and he throws across the diamond in time for out number two.
Now betting for the Dolphins, left fielder number 26, Tommy Joseph.
And here comes Tommy Joseph. The switch hitting left fielder bats left-handed here against the right-hander Lester. Lester sets and deals. Joseph toward the gap in left center field. That is in. And it is mishandled out and left by Hess. Joseph on his way to second base. So a single and an error on the left fielder Hess.
Batting for the Dolphins. First base.
Puts a man in scoring position for the first time here today for Jacksonville. And hitting in the three hole. Hopefully starting to find a little bit of a rhythm here for Jacksonville. His third hit of the season in 11 at-bats. Here is Christian Coypel. Runner in scoring position for Jacksonville's RBO. The lefty stands in, and Lester steps off the rubber and looks Joseph back to second. Lester making the first start of the season, the first start of his career here tonight. And he deals, and Coypel rips one foul into the pit. And look out. There are the railings there. A little over waist high, but everybody's piled up on him, so kind of stay alert. Nothing of the first inning, 2-0 Pitt. Jacksonville with a man in scoring position. The 0-1 from Lester. Breaking ball swung on and missed. Elevated it, and Coypel went after it, but could not get around. Nothing in two on Leppy. Lester sets a glance back to second and delivers the outside that Coypel lays off of. Mentioned Lester well-traveled, started his career at San Jacinto Community College started his career at Houston, then went to the community college route. Now with Pitt, and getting a chance just to career. The redshirt junior, the 1-2. And it is strike three called on the outside corner to Coypel, who shakes his head as he walks off back into the home dugout. That strands a man Pitt after one. You're listening to Jacksonville University Baseball from Van Wagner on the Jacksonville Dolphins Sports Network.
The latest Dolphin athletics gear and swag, visit jugear.com and stock up on.
Is Jacksonville University. It's not just a perfect place for sunny waterfront beauty shots. Although, here you choose the future you want. How? By defining it yourself. You customize your path and make it one of a kind. You want to build a future where you decide what impact you make? You want to create a life that's limited by nothing but your own ingenuity? You come to the right place.
This is Stephen Lucy, team physician for Jacksonville University. Baptist Health and Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute are the team behind your team, serving as the official sports medicine provider for Jacksonville University. JOI offers a complete range of orthopedic care and rehabilitation services to keep keep the Dolphins on the field and in the game. Don't you want to go where the pros go? Visit joi.net or call JOI2000 for more information.
Pitt. Head of the second inning here at John Sessions Stadium. Darkness settling in on a beautiful night for baseball here in Northeast Florida. Warm today, got up into the high 60s. Slight breeze. First pitch. Is a side to Brock Franks, the shortstop, the eight-hole hitter who starts things off. He went skipping out of the box. I don't know if he had a different read on that or what, but he's behind 0-1. Here is the next pitch, and an off-speed at the knees is called strike two. And Austin Temple hoping to get off to a smooth start here in inning number two after the somewhat tumultuous note. Here's the 0-2 pitch, and Franks easily lays off of a fastball that misses way upstairs. One-two pitch, changeup away, swung on and missed, and Franks down on strikes. That is back-to-back struck out by Austin Temple, dating back to last inning. And he gets the first out, a big first out here in the second. The only man he hasn't faced yet here tonight, Jordan Anderson, the center fielder. The first pitch of the right-handed swinging Anderson is a fastball in on the hands for ball one. Anderson, 2-for-10 this year, has started all four games for Pitt so far this season. The 1-0. Breaking ball at the knees for strike one. The 1-1, fastball away. Two-one pitch from Temple, fastball a little bit outside. Temple trying to avoid his first walk of the evening. Bases empty, one out. He is ready to go with the glove in front of his face. Anderson stepped out for a moment. Back in. Here's the 3-1 pitch. Grounded foul toward the Jacksonville dugout, and the count goes full. Temple has battled his way back in. We'll see if he can finish off the lanky Anderson, and he is unable to do so and is frustrated with himself as he overthrows a fastball down and away, blocked by Heffron, but a walk to Anderson, and now the lineup turns over for the first time tonight.
Sky Duff.
Runner on first, and here is Sky Duff. He doubled back in the first inning. Duff took it to left field, and it just kept carrying and carrying, and Tommy Joseph all of a sudden was looking up as it flew over his head. Anderson takes his lead off first. Temple from the stretch now against the lefty swinging Duff and goes off speed away for ball one. Anderson has not attempted a stolen base this year. The junior who started his career at Mississippi State was 6-for-7 a year ago as they throw over to check on him. And he's back in safely under the tag of Coy Pell. Duff back in the box. How about this? He has almost matched his double total from a year ago already. He's hit three at four all of last year. Another throw over to first to check on Anderson. This one a little bit closer. Duff with his double in the first inning now has three. So three of his five hit in the first inning now has three. So three of his five hits this season are doubles. Last season, five of his 15 hits were for extra bases, four of them being doubles. He finished the year hitting 306 in 16 games as a fastball just misses. Maybe a little bit up on that one. Two balls, no strikes to Sky Duff with the runner at first, one out. Pitt leading 2-0, top of the second. Temple with a deep breath. Now the 2-0. Fouled straight back to the left side. Pitt on a seven-game road trip to start the season in the state of Florida. Mentioned they just played in the Snowbird Classic last weekend with a series victory over Indiana State. Another throw over to first, and Anderson back in safely. Dropped the season opener 4-0. Won 8-2 and 10-1 on Saturday and Sunday. Trailed 2-1 in the top of the fifth on Saturday. Outscored Indiana State 17-1 the rest of the series. That's an offense finding itself in a hurry. The 2-1 pitch. A high fly ball out to left field. Joseph drifting back on it. Settles underneath right in front of the warning track. Reaches up and secures it for out number two. Anderson retreats back to first.
Now batting. Pitt right fielder.
Two outs here in the second, a runner at first, and Nico Popa back up. He drove in the first run of the game with his wall-scraping double an inning ago. For Popa, his first extra base hit of the season last inning, and his sixth of the season in 13 at-bats. He had just two extra base hits all of last year. Another throw over to first, and Anderson safely back in. Popa had a nice weekend down in Port Charlotte. 4-for-8, team-high 3 runs scored, drew 2 walks, drove in a run. Anderson takes his lead and takes off. The pitch inside for a ball. The throw down to second. Swipe tag from Pacheco, and Anderson ruled to have just beat it. Throw was just a little bit to the right, but really nice job by the freshman Pacheco to get over there, snag that, and make it look closer than it appeared it was going to be. Anderson with his first stolen base of the year. He's in scoring position with 2 outs in the second, and Pitt already enjoying a 2-0 lead. 1-0 the count on Popa. RBI opportunity again for him. The 1-0. Fastball down and away. Deep breath for Popa, the right-handed swinging right fielder. Awaits Temple's 2-0 offering. A long look to second base for the right-handed pitcher who delivers and blows a fastball up and in past Popa. Could not catch up, 2-1. Popa has started since his freshman season in 2017, second team All-ACC in 2019. As accomplished as any in this Pitt roster, which is pretty deep, the 2-1. Missing away from Popa, 3 balls and a strike. Kyle Hess awaiting on deck, the 3-hole hitter. Popa, twitchy down there, kind of gotten in, out, now he's in the box and awaits The 3-1. Temple gets the signs from Corey Heffron, sets and deals the 3-1 pitch. Down in the dirt, ball four. Blocked by Heffron. Anderson gave a look, but he retreats back to the bag at second. Second walk of the inning. Both Panthers that have reached here this inning have reached via free passes. And the inning continues for Kyle Hess, who popped out into foul territory back in the first.
Kyle Hess.
Runners at first and second, two outs. Austin Temple appeared to be on his way to, well, at the very least, a quicker inning than he had in the first. But things getting a little more difficult now with the second walk of the inning. He has thrown 38 pitches. Debut, and pitching coach Jerry Edwards decides he'd like to have a chat with Temple. Wondered exactly what the leash would be for Temple tonight anyway, coming off of a little bit of an injury issue in the offseason, as I mentioned. Figured he'd get a decent run here tonight, maybe a chance to go 50, 60 pitches, and then lengthen out a little bit more in his next outing. Still a little early to consider removing him, of course, but I think Jerry just wants to make sure that everybody's on the same page after that two-out walk with the dangerous hitter at the plate. And Edwards on a trot back to the dugout, and we're ready for action again. Runners at first and second, two outs. Pitt leading 2-0, top of the second, threatening again. And mentioned a dangerous hitter at the plate. Kyle Hess, two doubles, three RBI last weekend. 0-for-1 here tonight. First pitch, down to the dirt, blocked by Heffron, and Anderson takes off, and Heffron can't handle it. He is in safely into third. Heffron popped up, may have had a chance at third, would have taken a very good throw. But as he picked up the baseball, it slipped out of his hands and allowed Anderson to get in with no trouble to third base. Runners at the corners as Popa did not go on that play. And a 1-0 count to Hess. Two outs here in the inning. The 1-0. Called strike one on the outside corner. A changeup away there for Austin Temple. And a big bat at bat here for Pitt and Austin Temple on the mound. The 1-1. Fly ball out into left, and Joseph on the run. Will he be able to make the play? No, it lands in front of him, and an RBI single for Hess the opposite way. Joseph was playing pretty deep out in left field, and that one lands in front of him. And Hess drives in a run to make it 3-0. And Pitt taking advantage of a couple of free base runners here in the second.
Ron Washington.
And the first hit of the inning is a run scoring hit. Popa moved down to second base on the play. Now runners at first and second, still two outs. And here is Ron Washington Jr., who drove in a run back an inning ago as well, as he went the opposite way with a single. First pitch. And it's inside on Washington, who backs out of the way of ball one. Washington. We'll not get a chance to see another pitch from Austin Temple, because here is head coach Chris Hayes out of the dugout, and that is it. So a frustrating season opening start for Austin Temple, who throws 39 pitches here tonight and allows three runs on four hits. And a pitching change coming for Jacksonville. Let you know who the new arm is for the Dolphins when we return.
3-0, Pitt leads. Two outs, runners at first and second in the top of the second. You're listening to Jacksonville University Baseball from Van Wagner on the Jacksonville Dolphins Sports Network.
To stay on top of your game, it's important to take good care of yourself. And that's exactly what Baptist Primary Care doctors specialize in, helping you know the score when it comes to your health. And with more than 1,400 physicians in our network, Baptist Primary Care is your direct link to all of Baptist Health. To establish a relationship with a Baptist Primary Care doctor near you, call 202-CARE. Baptist Health, proud to be the official healthcare provider for JU Athletics.
At the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute, we are dedicated to providing you state-of-the-art rehabilitation and physical therapy designed to meet your specific needs. With an expert staff of physical and occupational therapists committed to providing individual attention, we offer comprehensive care at 10 convenient locations. JOI provides sports medicine services to professional, collegiate, and high school athletes, and also have two comprehensive spine centers, which offer massage, laser, and acupuncture therapy. We are Jacksonville's Orthopedic Institute and an official partner of the Jacksonville Dolphins. Adrian Garastazu takes over on the mound for Jacksonville, replacing the right-hander Austin Temple, who's partial mind tonight, an inning in two-thirds. Three runs on four hits, walked two, struck out two, and is responsible for the men at first and second right now. It's already a 1-0 count on Ron Washington Jr. as Garastazu makes his second appearance of the season through an inning of scoreless baseball in which he struck out the side on Saturday. The redshirt junior from Hialeah, Florida, climbs onto the mound, rocking the high stirrup socks, and assumes a 1-0 count with two outs against the designated hitter, Washington. Garastazu works from the third base side of the rubber, gets the signs from Heffron, and he's ready to go with his first pitch here of the night. He deals. Fastball away for ball one. Ball two, excuse me. With the count already being 1-0. For Austin Temple, it's going to look worse than it was because of the fact that it's a 2-0 pitch, check swing, foul ball. I thought he had moments tonight where he executed pretty well. He got really burned by a unnecessarily tight strike zone in the first inning. Came out, started off this inning, or he closed out the first and kind of rolled that into the second pretty strong, and then the command just wasn't quite where we have seen from Temple, especially last year. And that'll just take a little time, the 2-1. Down and away. And maybe a little bit of frustration boiled over at times for Temple tonight as well. All of a sudden, you start thinking, I got to be perfect, or why isn't this guy giving me the call? And you don't execute that pitch the same way you would as if you were settled in. And he's a pretty even temperament guy as well, Austin on the mound. Runners on first and second, two outs, the 3-1, and it is low, I believe, for ball four to Washington, who walks. Base is now loaded. That is the third walk this inning issued by Jacksonville pitching. And this is something that plagued the Dolphins opening weekend as well. JU walked 18 batters through the first three games of the season. Struck out a lot too, but you don't like to put that many free guys on. Here's David Ianni, who was hit by a pitch his first time up. The lefty stands in, bases loaded, two outs. First pitch he sees is a called strike. Breaking ball clips the outside corner from Garastazu. Garastazu trying to put out the fire here in the second and keep Jacksonville within relatively close striking distance in the early goings in this one. He sets it, fires the 0-1 pitch, and a breaking ball that ends up in the right-handed batter's box. Ball and a strike, the count to Yanni. And Pitt has been a patient team at the plate, and with good reason. Force Jacksonville to execute pitches. Dolphins pitching has some, but not enough. And Pitt has made them pay when they haven't, either drawing walks or punishing baseballs. Bases loaded, two outs, the 1-1. Breaking ball, check swing. Appealing to see if he went, he did not. Yanni ahead now 2-1 on really nice pitch there from Garastazu. Yanni thought a long time about that one before holding up. Garastazu trying to even things back up here. The 2-1. Fastball at the letters for a strike. And he's a strike away from leaving three men on base. Yanni became the ninth man hit by Jacksonville's pitching staff this season back in the first. Bases loaded, two outs. A deep breath, and the 2-2. Strike three called, ball three. And the sparse crowd here at John Session Stadium on this Tuesday night now letting the umpire know. He has been more inconsistent than the temperature swings we have had here on the First Coast in the last couple weeks. Payoff pitch. Popped up in the infield, into foul territory. Shedding the mask, Heffron up the third baseline, reaches back and makes the grab. And Jacksonville gets out of it without allowing an additional run, but Pitt gets one more on the RBI single from Kyle Hess. Lead 3-0 as we head to the bottom of the second. Dolphins bringing Heffron, Moffitt, and DeLamelaar to the plate when we return. You're listening to Jacksonville University Baseball from Van Wagner on the Jacksonville Dolphins Sports Network. Shenantry Chiropractic.
Is hip or knee pain getting in the way of doing the things you love? Waiting to see the doctor could be making your condition worse. If you've had any of the five hip or knee symptoms that shouldn't be ignored, like pain or discomfort while sitting, driving, walking, exercising, or even sleeping, and haven't found relief from anti-inflammatory medicine, it's time to see the specialist at Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute. Our physicians offer new and innovative treatments for hip and knee pain. And the doctors at JOI are Jacksonville's most experienced at using Makoplasty, a state-of-the-art surgical technique that harnesses robotic technology for precision placement of hip and knee implants. Don't live with hip or knee pain a moment longer. Make an appointment today with a hip and knee specialist from Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute. Call 904-JOI-2000. That's 904-564-2000.
Heffron leads off the Pitt leads.
If your driveway needs cleaning, you're with
Pitt with two in the first, one in the second. And Jacksonville trying to get on the scoreboard here now. Heffron to be followed by Moffitt, then DeLamelaar. And Lester back out for another inning of work, and he rockets in a fastball at the knees for strike one. I am sure that Dylan Lester is happy to be working with the lead, but he'd probably like to be pitching a little more often here as we have played almost an hour of baseball and he's barely been out there. Breaking ball on the inside half called strike two. He threw just 10 pitches to get out of the first, stranded a man in scoring position, Tommy Joseph, who singled and reached second on an error. And now the 0-2 to Heffron. Down in the dirt and skips away from Wash. Heffron hit his third career home run in a Jacksonville uniform on Saturday. One of his two hits so far, and he takes strike three called. And Heffron with a few words for the home plate umpire as he walks back to the dugout. That was, I don't know, a ball, two off? I mean,
betting for the Dolphins, designated hitter.
Probably better off flipping a coin at this point than having a guy actually behind the plate, because it probably is consistent. Here's Stephen Moffitt. First pitch swinging, high fly ball out to deep right field. This is a foul ball by about a foot. Nice to see the aggressive attack there, from Stephen Moffitt, starting as a designated hitter today, has just one previous at-bat, a pinch hit spot on Saturday. Moffitt drew a walk in that one plate appearance. Now the 0-1. Breaking ball. A little bit up. Ball one. Base is empty. One out. 3-0 Pitt. Bottom of the second inning. Lester kicks and deals. Fastball. Maybe a little low. Folks, it's just a guessing game. This isn't even a partial thing, one side or the other. I mean, this home plate umpire is blind. I mean, that looked like a strike every day of the week to me there, too. Surprised that one didn't get called one. Ball three. Now, Moffitt does, I would say, have a pretty good batting eye. He walked more than he struck out a year ago, the 3-1. That pitch, which was a ball two pitches ago, this time a strike. Full count. Third baseman Duff heads over to the line, trying to guard against Moffitt turning on one payoff pitch, and he slices one to the first baseman Hewlett, who makes the catch right before it touches the dirt for out number two.
Betting for the Dolphins, right fielder number 23. Blake
DeLamelor. Here's DeLamelor, the freshman. Blake DeLamelor, a local product just down the road, Bartram Trail High School. Started the second game of the doubleheader on Saturday. Second start of his career. He went 1-for-4. First pitch he sees, fastball high and away for ball one. Duff now creeps in to the edge of the infield grass at third base. Outfield playing DeLamelor straight up. Two outs, base is empty. 3-0 Pitt. 1-0 pitch is a called strike, a breaking ball in the outside corner. Ball and a strike to DeLamelor. A 1-1. Off speed on the inside corner this time, called strike two. Now time for DeLamelor to protect. Anything close. He's back into the box. And Lester fires the 1-2 pitch. And it's a fastball low and outside. Two-two. Dommler swings through an elevated heater and strikes out, bookending the inning with K's. Lester Strong through two, and the Pitt Panthers lead 3-0 with two in the books here at John Sessions Stadium. You're listening to Jacksonville University Baseball from Van Wagner on the Jacksonville Dolphins Sports Network.
The Dolphins nothing.
If your driveway needs cleaning, your windows need washing, or your pavers need sealing, you need Crystal Clean. Don't forget your roof needs cleaning too. Crystal Clean uses soft washing, a low-pressure water system with special cleaners out damaging delicate areas. Call 904-220-3337 or go to crystalclean.com. We promise to make your home crystal clean.
At Law Offices of George Hunter, PA, we commit to a cooperative process to get the job done to the client's ultimate satisfaction. With a client-first focus, our firm applies an extraordinary work ethic to effectively resolve legal issues. Contact us today at 813-856-2096. Law Offices of George Hunter, a proud partner of Jacksonville University Athletics.
Baseball in Jacksonville, Florida. 3-0 Pitt leading Jacksonville. Panthers looking for a third straight win to open up the season.
Out here, we'd show
Jordan Anderson.
Jacksonville trying to pick up that first win of the year. We'll have to do so in come from behind fashion. Here is Jordan Anderson. Excuse me. This is